Is everybody in? The ceremony is about to begin.
Wake up!
Indian Summer was a cut that we
recorded in 1966 here for the first album.
Right, and it took till the fifth album to get on. And it's such a gentle Ravi Shankar-influenced tune. I'm playing my hands on the verses of the drum kit, sort of tapping it like tablas. And then I use the stick a little bit. It's so beautiful, the melody. Oh.
And Jim's voice, he's so young, you can really hear it.
It's so delicate.
Here it goes.
Indian Summer might be the one song that kind of stands out as less a piece of the whole than the other songs. You can hear it in the riffing that Ravi is doing on the lick that is almost straight out of the end, that sort of Indian kind of modal lick that he's doing. Better than all. But it's a very sweet song. That's the thing about it. And it's, you know, in this album where there's a lot of sort of, you know, raw, hard-hitting stuff, this is such a beautiful, beautiful song that it's hard to imagine the album without it, even though it doesn't feel like it fits as much with the others. But it's a compliment to the others. It's a light in the darkness in some ways, and I think that really helps a lot.
That's the first time I've played that in 50 years, too. See, that could have been a hit single. But you know what? That was the very first song we recorded. Right. When we came here, and we said, "Oh man, we can do better than that."
Well, it's such a nice mood.
Yeah, but it's so unhard rock. You know, I think we were thinking, "Oh, we got to be, you know, light my fire and like that." So at that point in our recording career, it was just too laid back and vulnerable sounding. But I'm glad we used it on this record.
The Morrison Hotel was really a kind of a flea bag hotel. It was a flop house. So the whole lobby had this kind of old funky furniture, like from a Salvation Army store or something. And there was only one person in the lobby, and it was a young guy behind the desk over there. The doors walked into the lobby. Gary walked in with him, and I stopped at the desk. I said, "We're just going to be over there taking a few pictures. You know, nobody was in there." So I said, we'll be cool. He said, "No. No, you can't. You can't take any pictures." He was really adamant about it. So I walked over to the guys. I said, "You know, they're not going to let us shoot in here. So let's walk outside." And I thought, well, they could stand in front of the window. Then I saw a light go on at the back of the lobby. And I looked through the window and I said, "It's the elevator light." And look, the guy left his desk. He went up in the elevator. And I honestly said, "Quick, you guys run in there."
We had to sneak into the Morrison Hotel, which was a real place, and quickly do the photo and run out because they didn't want us to do it.
So we took one roll of film and they ran out. But the guy never saw us, never came down from the elevator.
Good. Better than all.